Sega.
What's up, everyone, and welcome to Sonic Generations. Ignore me selecting a hard drive. Welcome to Sonic Generations for the Xbox 360. This game is, of course, the next Let's Play project, and it was released to celebrate Sonic's 20th anniversary 10 years ago. Yes, Sonic Generations is 10 years old. It features a lot of stuff from the series past. And I'm super excited to play this. I played it back when it first came out on my old laptop and it ran like garbage. But I am playing this on the Xbox 360. It also came out for PS3. There's also a 3DS version, which is completely different, which I may eventually cover in the future. But for now, we're going to go ahead and hit new game and get started here with Sonic Generations. That's kind of ominous. Look at that. They're shrouded in darkness. Let's just keep it standard. Hint display, I think we will keep that on. And I wonder what's going on here. This strange-looking spring is a decoy. It'll send you off in the wrong direction, so watch out! Yeah, they're just throwing us straight in here. And look at that, it seems we are playing a little bit of classic Sonic the Hedgehog right here. Now, The last time I covered a Sonic game was back in 2018. I believe, when I did Sonic and Sega All-Stars Racing. But the last time that I played a mainline Sonic game before that was Sonic Lost World in 2017. And then before that I did Colors, I've covered 06 before, and also Heroes. So Generations is one that I've wanted to do since pretty much the launch of my channel, honestly. Because, oh god, Omochao scared me. Also, I believe that there are options for subtitles, but we don't have them on right now, so I'm gonna ensure that I actually check that. It may have been in that original thing where it's like, hey, do you want the hints on? But yeah, you can turn on subtitles so that you can just read what Omochao is saying. Anyways, I'm super excited to be playing this game, super excited to be bringing it to you guys, because it is arguably one of the best modern Sonic games. That is what most people seem to think. I would have to agree. I missed going up to the top platform there, but no biggie. I would have to agree that I think it is one of the best modern Sonic games, and of course it also includes, as you can see right here, classic Sonic. But we'll figure out exactly what's going on and why we're playing as him right now in, we're gonna say 2011, because that's when this came out. Okay, I guess I'm not going that way. We also just missed out on speed shoes right there. I haven't really been explaining what I've been doing here. Omochao's kind of been doing the most of it. But you can press the X button to do your spin dash, which gives you that immediate boost of speed. Looks like we might be at the end here. Yeah. You jump with A, and that's about it. Let's see. Oh, we got an achievement for completing the first level, the opening act. Got a rank A, and because we didn't die, a rank S, and Bright Star, another achievement right there. I actually made a new Xbox profile so that we could get achievements as we go.
He'll be here any second.
guys, what's going on? You having a party or something?
Surprise!
Aw, you guys.
It's kind of impossible to surprise you.
You totally got me this time. I had no idea.
Yeah, right. Happy birthday, Sonic. Hope you like this.
Like it? I love it! What?
Sonic, what's that? What's it doing?
Well, this place looks oddly familiar. Real quick, do we have any options? I don't think our options are in there. Yeah, I think we're gonna have to wait before we can turn on our subtitles, unfortunately, but that's fine. I guess let's see what's going on here. Question mark, question mark, question mark, act two. Let's go. I wonder where we could be. If you haven't gathered, given that this is act two and what we just played before was considered act one, this is somewhere we've been before. I think that the first level probably would have given it away. But, I won't say anything until the game does, but I think we all know exactly where we are. Now, modern Sonic right here, this is my preferred playstyle in this game. I kind of adore playing as modern Sonic. I screwed up getting in that ring right there, but that's fine. Modern Sonic, of course, uses the boost formula. You can drift right here, as you can see. You got the homing attack. It's considerably more fast-paced than playing as Classic Sonic, but I don't dislike Classic Sonic. I do dislike missing this jump that I wanted to go for right here. So this stage right here, I am super familiar with. This is, of course, being the first stage I've played it the most. So I'm really not surprised that I'm super familiar with it. So I'm gonna be trying. Okay, it's not here. It's here. There's another jump right here. I'm gonna be trying to take all the shortcuts I can, is what I was saying. Now these, for some reason, the thing's not appearing on screen. The little button prompt, but you just push in different directions to do tricks, and then you hit R and L, or LB and RB, to do that final trick. Also, I recommend doing this. Jump into the middle, you miss a whole bunch of loops, and it just makes you go a little bit faster. Yeah, we got a one-up. Nice. Yeah, right here. I'm gonna press down, left, up, right, and then the bumpers together, and it gives us a little bit more on our boost gauge right there. I'm not quite sure why our, oh, I missed that. Damn it. I'm not quite sure why the little tutorial things aren't appearing on screen, but again, we'll figure that out whenever we get to, view our options. Oh, another move that Modern Sonic has is a stomp right here. As you can see, you press B to do a little bit of a stomp, and you just go straight down. And I think we're gonna get some use out of that in a little bit here. Oh, I screwed that up. Oh well. We're definitely gonna get some use out of that in a little bit here. Because there's a section coming up. I think we're close to it. Maybe? Is it right over here? No, never mind. There's a section coming up where we're gonna get some use out of that. Also, if we're moving, we press B. We do a little slide. If we tap A, we do a short hop, which I failed to do right there. Okay, right here. If we stomp. Okay, stomp. You'll go through the floor. And I think it's considered a little bit of a shortcut. And if we drift, our boost gauge doesn't go down. So I recommend doing that during this section right here. But I do believe... Combo 5, we are right at the end of the level now. Let's just keep on boosting, destroying these badniks. There's the goal ring. I do believe we did good enough there to get another A rank. I mean, S rank. Well, there's our A, perfect bonus. There's our S. Alrighty.
Thanks, Sonic. I thought I was dead, floating without a body in a black limbo. I'm gonna have nightmares for weeks.
Is it me, or is that place we were just in awfully familiar?
Not to me, but this place looks like something sucked all the life and color out of it. Totally strange.
No stranger than rescuing genies in magic books or saving aliens in an interstellar amusement park. I'm more concerned about finding our friends.
Hey, Sonic, I saw something over there in the distance. Like buildings, but they look weird.
That might be a good place to check out. I'll be back soon.
Wow, you weren't kidding when you said soon. I thought you already left.
If you haven't gathered, that was Green Hill Zone, and there are indeed two Sonics, Classic Sonic and Modern Sonic. And Green Hill Restored, nice! The reason why Tails wasn't familiar with Green Hill is because Green Hill's from Sonic 1 and Tails was not in Sonic 1. Alrighty, so to end off this episode, I say end off, we're not quite at the end yet, we're gonna go ahead and switch to Classic Sonic. Just by pressing the Y button here, Tails is not here. Oh, yes he is. Oh, look, it's Baby Tails!
Hey there! Hey there! If you can manage to get an A-rank score without losing a life, you'll get an S-rank!
Thanks, buddy. I need to find my options. Are they over here? Do you have the options in you? I don't believe you do. This is a skill shop, where we can use the points that we get at the end of levels to, buy skills. But we're not gonna be worrying about that just yet. I guess it's not in here. Do we not have options? I swear we did. This is Sonic's Memories in the Collection Room. New items are added as you collect red star rings and notes. Come back anytime to check your collection. I thought this is where the options were. Maybe not. I'll figure that out between episodes. Anyway, folks, because we've switched back over to Classic Sonic, let's talk to Tails right here. Never mind. I saw a red star ring too. Give it a try. All right, we are going to be heading back into both acts, both the classic one and the modern one, and grabbing all five red star rings. There's five red star rings in classic and five red star rings in modern, and we're gonna be getting them all throughout this let's play. So let's head on in here as Classic Sonic, and there you go, it tells you you can switch, and we're gonna go ahead and try and grab these. They were not available on our first playthrough, unfortunately. You can play Act 1 and Act 2 in any order. Act 1 tends to be easier. Clear an act to proceed to the next stage, yada yada yada. Let's jump back in here. Now, I think I know where all of these are. I could be completely wrong. I'm probably going to be cutting around just a little bit to ensure that we do get them all, but... Boost! Alright. Yeah, I know who you are, Omochao. In fact, the first one is literally right there. For some reason, they just put it, like, right just on your path, which I'm definitely not complaining about, but it's there. Alright, the next one... The next one, I believe, is actually going to be right here. We got to bounce off of this guy. Huh? Yeah. Was it here? Yes, no, maybe so? Was it? Oh, yeah, there it is. It was on that loop. And then I'm going to just go ahead and start cutting around to these because I don't want to have to show you the whole level again. So I'll meet you back when we find number 3. Oh, actually, I think number 3 might be down here. Am I right? I think number 3 is literally right here. We just hop onto this little platform, take it... Oh, maybe not. Maybe I'm remembering this wrong. Quite possible. Oh, wait, it was right there. Oh, it was right there. I don't think we can get that now. I think I've missed it. Unless there's a way back, which there could be right here. Looks like we can do that. All right, hold on. Let's try that again. Just move this way. No, not like that. Turn around, spin dash, jump, hold back. Ugh. And then do it right here. There we go. That's where our next one was. All right, onward to number 4. All right, the next one is in this section right here. Swing on this platform. And there it is. And then the next one, we get to this little badnik right here. We got to jump off of him and bounce up. And then I believe bounce off of this guy too. Let me double check by going over here first. Yeah, we got to bounce off of this guy. Wait for him to come back. Yeah, yeah, do your thing. Nope, that was bad angle. Bounce off of him, bounce on the spring, and that is all 5 of the Red Star medals, Red Star rings, whatever you want to call them, from Act 1 of Green Hill. I've actually never collected all of these in this game. I don't think I've ever collected them all in any Sonic game, so this Let's Play is going to be my first time doing that. I still have yet to go back and do it in Sonic Colors. I know I said that I would do that many times during that Let's Play, but I still have not gone back to do it, so we'll get there eventually. Jump for joy! We've got yet another achievement. Sonic seems very happy about that. And another S rank as well. Alright, but of course, we're not quite done. Because we also have the modern act to go through and grab all of the Red Star rings in. And honestly, I think this one's going to be a little bit easier because I played it so many times. You got a Red Star ring! Your item collection will grow as you collect Red Star rings. To see your new items, head left to go to your collection room. You got artwork 1, you got artwork 2, 3, 4, and 5. And then you got treasure scanner, which is a skill. Skills have different effects like damage protection or increasing speed. Put them to good use in your adventures. Skills can be equipped in the skill shop or by selecting skill customization at the stage gate. And as you can see, that turns into a nice little red, big red star ring. Let's see. I'm curious what that one actually was right there. Wait, what was it called? Where'd it go? Where's the one we just got? Or did it give it to us? We don't have to buy it. Is that what it is? Yeah, we can equip our skills in here. Customize. We have treasure scanner. Allows you to see hidden items and springs. I guess we'll put that on. And then we have power break. Stop on a dime regardless of your speed. I don't really want that one, honestly. But I think we will actually buy something if we have enough. We do. We have quite a lot of points. Land on your feet after getting damage requires 20 skill points. Begin with 10 rings after a restart. Get an extra life when you're out of lives. Dropped rings take 10 seconds to disappear. Lose less speed moving uphill and in water. A shield. Blast off. Oh, I'm going to get blast off. That one's really good. The second that go appears, if you hit boost, you get a boost. And I guess I'll also get this speed up one. The Sega Genesis controller allows you to just play the original Sonic game, which is pretty cool. We'll definitely check that out in the future whenever we end up getting that. And I guess I... Oh, wait. I don't think I saved it. Let me confirm. Confirm that. Okay, but then I believe that the other ones are for modern Sonic only? Because, of course, classic Sonic doesn't have the boost. So, let's see here. Skill customization, please. Skill set A. Customize. Yeah, okay, so we'll put on Blast Off and Speed Up for this Sonic. Because, of course, we're heading in as this Sonic now, so let's do this. Alright, back to Green Hill we go. Let's go on in and get these Red Star Rings. I know where the first one is. Like hands down, I just know where it is because it's fairly close to the start of the level. And hopefully we can get it the first try. I know that I made it look pretty easy. I got all of the Red Star Rings in the Classic Act first time through. Also, there's Blast Off. But they're not always that easy. There's the first one. I missed it. We now cannot go back. So I have to start over. Yeah, some of them are like that. So not all the time, but you're not always going to be able to get all of them on your first time through, if that makes sense. I feel like I'm making some sense. There we go. I believe the next one is right after this first big loop. We want to make sure that we take the high path here. Get in this rainbow hoops right here. Yeah. Hit these enemies with a homing attack, and there's our next one. Next up in the grind rail section, right towards the end of it. You want to get onto the right-hand side path, and there it is. And then right after that section, you want to take the lower path here. I boosted just a little bit too far. And then just keep following the lower path around. Okay, I guess I fell in the pit. Sonic? Sonic, buddy, please tell me we're not stuck down here. There we go, I was about to say. You go down the lower path, just keep going until you get to a grind rail, which I think is just after this. Maybe? Keep going still? Damn, this lower path is longer than I expected. Here we go, grind rail. It's gonna send us through yet another rainbow hoop onto yet another grind rail, and then the red star ring is gonna be right there. And then the final red star ring is going to be on the last section. Stay in the right-hand lane over here. Never mind, it was in the middle. Stop, Sonic. Oh, my God. Please tell me we can go back and get that. I really hope there's no boost panels in the middle. Whoa, there it is. There it is. Okay, now we can finish the level, no problem. That should be all five. Definitely thought that I was going to have to replay the entire level just to get that last red star ring right there, but pretty damn glad that we didn't. And there's another S rank. And now that we've done that, of course the big red ring is going to show up for Modern Sonic as well. Just as soon as we get back, there we go. You got artwork 6, 7, 8, 9, and something else, whatever that was. We got another skill, I guess let's go check that out. What was it, like acceleration it said? Oh wait, no, it's down here, skill customization. Skill set A, let's see what we can add. We have acceleration, increases speed while starting to run. I'll definitely go ahead and turn that on, why not? And with that, I believe we're going to go ahead and call it an episode here, folks. Next time on Sonic Generations, we're going to head into whatever this mysterious level happens to be. I definitely don't recognize it at all from the aesthetics or from the music that's playing right now. Woo! Anyways, if you guys enjoyed this first episode of Sonic Generations, please make sure to let me know by leaving a like. And of course, let me know what you thought of it in the comment section below. Stay tuned for the next one, and I'll see you guys then.